Let's go!
No, because any motion you do on Segway is the same one you usually do when you walk. So you have to control your body, you have to control your legs, you have to move your weight forward to go forward. So it's exactly the same thing that you usually do when you walk. And they are pretty safe because we don't leave our guests alone. So we are always with them during the tour. We show them the best places to stop, to leave the Segway, to take pictures. So we take care about cars, people, so they are never alone. And in case they don't feel safe enough with us, we can provide helmets, even if they're not compulsory. The Italian law doesn't oblige us to wear helmets with Segway, but we have, so.
Yeah, for the sake of not looking like a dork, I didn't wear a helmet. So it was safe even without
a
helmet.
They are not really fashion, but they are absolutely safe.
Do you need to get a phone?
No.
Oh, was it beeping? That's beeping?
Yes.
Oh, okay, that was beeping. I didn't know.
The Segway has a phone.
Oh, the Segway. Hello. Okay. Wow. Now, you have the tour that only covers a particular area of Florence. Why is that?
Yeah, we have a specific path to follow because for security reason, we found a specific route together with the town hall of Florence. So we found out the best path to proceed during the tour in safety and to see the most important things of the city.
And your tour was wonderful, very informative.
Thanks.
Things that you don't even find in guidebooks or even if you Google or even search for. I mean, that's something like only a local would know, and that's very valuable.
That's what we try to do, to give people the chance to see Florence from a different point of view, not only due to the Segway that you are taller than the others, but to give information that usually are not reported on the guided book, or usually people don't know because there are some curiosity about the city. That's what we try to do too.
Firenze stanotte si pela il manto di stelle.
After visiting the Duomo, Florence's religious center, and the Segway, we're off to visit Piazza della Repubblica, Florence's commercial center.
La bocca tremanti si parla d'amore. Il torna accettata poesia per te, vita mia, sospira il mio cuore.
Piazza della Repubblica has a long history, having first been a Roman forum. In the medieval times, this square was as densely built over as the rest of Florence was. I mean, there was such a lack of available land for housing that people started to build cassatori, or tower houses. Yup, those were the medieval skyscrapers. But still, there was just enough room to include a marketplace called the Mercato Vecchio, or the Old Market. In 1885, during the brief time that Florence served as the capital of Italy, major overhaul improvements took place in Florence. Many buildings were also torn down in this piazza to broaden it. Also, in celebration of Florence's short stint as Italy's capital, a triumphal arch was also built on the piazza. An inscription on the arch clearly states the sentiments of the Florentines prior to the renovations. The ancient center of the city, restored from age-old squalor to new life. On top of an old salvage column from the old market is a statue of abundance. Among the square's most popular cafes is the Giuberose Cafe, a former hangout for famous artists and writers, especially those of Italy's avant-garde futurist movement. Here you also find many artists selling their masterpieces and live music performed day and night.
Thank you.
For your shopping pleasure, there's also a department store, Rinascente, a chain of Italian department stores equivalent to Macy's. There's more to this department stores and shopping. Come with me and I'll show you. Isn't this not an amazing view of the piazza below and the top of the Duomo? Wow! You can celebrate this great view with an espresso at the cafe up here. Now we're heading to Florence's most famous piazza, Piazza della Signoria.